first one was so popular, I'm so glad you guys liked it. So hopefully this will just give you some options to that. So if you haven't checked out the first one, you can definitely check out Pilates for Scoliosis Part 1 and then add this to your routine as well. So we're going to work mostly on just a movement through the spine, and I'll talk as we go along. So I'm going to be sitting here on the ground, but if this isn't comfortable for you, and it definitely might not be, you're just going to find something to sit on, 2 inches, 4 inches, 6 inches, whatever you need. You can even sit in a chair and do this entire warm-up that we're going to do. So it's whatever is going to be comfortable for you. That's what matters, that you can have both sit bones down and then you can be up in this nice tall posture. I know that your curve is going to throw you a little bit one side to the other. That's why I want you to sit up if you need to. So I want you to just find that level that you need to sit on that's going to allow you to feel as tall as possible and allow your hips to relax a little bit. Okay, so once you find that, come on back and we will start. So what we're going to do is just have the hands on either side, and I want you literally to start to feel a little bit longer in each side waist, but let your shoulder blades drop down. So that's going to be one of the keys to this, is feeling the shoulder blades down as the spine gets nice and tall. We're going to sweep the left arm up and just lean over for what we call a mermaid stretch. It's just a simple side bend, and we're going to come right back up. Bring the left arm down, right arm over, and sweep it over. And we're going to do quite a few of these in this warm-up. So this is really meant to actually re-educate your spine. So I don't just want 2 or 3 stretches for people with scoliosis. Stretches are great, but 1 or 2 stretches isn't going to make a big difference as much as literally retraining your body how to move. One direction is going to feel much different to you, obviously, than the other direction when you're doing these side bends. And you're just going to go with it. I don't want you to judge yourself. I don't want you to get upset where you feel tight. All you're doing is letting your body move a little bit. Feel the movement. Feel the tightness. That's cool. It's fine. And you're just kind of working into those tight spaces a little bit. And maybe each time you go over, you're getting a little bit looser or a little bit longer. So on this one, we're gonna reach over, stay there, just for that nice open stretch, try to keep the sit bone down, and let's lift, bring the hand down and over to the other side. And then back up. All right, so that was our side bend. We're gonna do a similar exercise for rotation. So I want you to bring your hands up towards the ceiling. We're gonna rotate to the left first. You're gonna come down. Your right hand comes to the outside of your knee. Your left hand comes behind you. You're gonna come back up and switch sides. And again, all of these you can just do sitting in a chair or sitting wherever you need to. It's more the idea of either side bending or rotating through the spine. Motions that your spine may not have done in quite a long time. Inhale, and then the breathing is important as well. Exhale and inhale. Breathing is going to help your spine move. So just find a breath pattern that works for you. And rotate. And up. And we'll just do a few more here. Again, it might seem like a lot of repetition, but that is the point. That's what I want. I want repetition and consistency, which if you've watched the other video, you know I talk a lot about. And up. Okay, so on this one, we're going to go over, and again, we're just going to stay there. You don't need to really crank or twist on your spine here. It's just a gentle rotation. I really want more that idea of lifting up, pulling the belly button in towards the spine. And let's sweep the arms up. And go to the other side. And again, maybe a gentle rotation and then a lift. Rotate, lift. So you'll see there's Pilates exercises through this and principles. There's a little bit of yoga. There's definitely physical therapy that I use for my patients. And then let's come back up. Arms come down, and I want you to walk yourself out. And we're just getting a stretch in the back, but also a stretch in the hips, especially if your legs are crossed at all. You're going to feel this in your hips. And let's just walk back up. If your legs are crossed, just cross them the other way. If they aren't, that's okay. Just leave your legs where they are, and we'll just do the same thing. Just forward fold or walk yourself out. walk back up from there. And then we're gonna come around onto all fours. So some of these exercises are gonna be similar video to video because they're so important for the spine. Let's start here, hands under the shoulders, knees under the hips. And let's exhale to round. And then inhale to arch. It just lets you practice a little more. It lets you add some different components. And here too, I don't want you to worry. The key is not worrying about what spots are moving, what spots aren't moving. Just move. Just let your body move. And if it's a little bit tight there, that's okay. See if you can maybe put a little more breath into the tight spots. Or maybe just go a little bit slower in the tight spots. But your body will find a way to move where it needs to if you're consistent with these exercises. Okay, let's go halfway in between. So this is your neutral spine. This is going to be a little different. It's a side bend. What I want you to do is think about having a tail, and you're going to twist and look at your hip. So I'm looking over my left shoulder. I'm sticking my left hip over to the left and trying to look at it. Then I'm coming to the other side and trying to look at my right hip. So it's like I have a tail and I'm just wagging my tail side to side, looking at my tail, then the other way. Keep pressing away from the hands. We'll just do one more in each direction. And then let's come back to center. Knees come wide, press back for a child's pose. And then here too, we're gonna add some stretches. I want you to walk your hands over to the left, let the right hand cross on top. Let's stretch out the right side. And let's come back to center and take it to the other side. And then we're gonna come back up to all fours and add some strengthening to that. So we're gonna find your neutral spine again, which means you're gonna round and then you're gonna arch. And then you're going to find a halfway point in between those two. And I want you to bring your right arm out in front of you. So the key here is not letting your spine move at all when you do this. I don't want your tail to stick up. I don't want your abs to drop. And then you might just hold this if you're okay with it. The left leg is going to go back behind you. So now I have my right arm reaching forward, left leg reaching back, and my belly is pulling in. So we're strengthening every muscle in your core and in your back here. It's called spinal balance. And let's just come back down and find the other side. Take the left arm in front of you. So it's really important not only to stretch and get movement in the spine, but then to strengthen the areas around it. Now take your right leg back. And breathe. And then come back. And we're going to do that again, alternating sides. Right arm, left leg. Slowly come back down, left arm, right leg. And just check yourself each time to make sure that the spine isn't moving around, that you're keeping the core engaged. Feel like you have a glass of water on your back and on your tailbone, and you're trying to balance it there. And let's make this one the last one. And come back. All right, we're going to take it straight into a plank. I want you to take your hands forward slightly, knees come back, knees together, and we're going to shift forward into a plank on our knees. We're going to start with a modified plank here. Make sure the elbows aren't locked. So another great way to engage the core is to work on planking. Squeeze the legs together, nice long spine. If you have wrist or shoulder issues, you can do this down on your elbows right here, which is just fine. Okay, now let's just take it back. So your choice, we're going to do another plank. You can either stay on your knees or you can come up onto your toes. So I'll show you toes version. If you're going to do toes, separate your legs to hip distance and lift up onto your toes. And again, we're just going to breathe and hold it. Make sure the elbows aren't locked. You're nice and long here. All right, now from here, I want you to take it back into an inverted V. If you're familiar with yoga, it's similar to down dog. This also, you could just do on your knees if you need to. All right, now what I want you to do, this is gonna be a little bit different and a little advanced. You're gonna round out your spine. Okay, so from here, think cat. So instead of being a flat spine, I want you to round, round, round. You're going to come forward over your toes and then lift. And here is your extension. Okay, over your toes, round, back into your flexion. So this is just like our cat camel that we did, except it's up. And we'll do one more onto long arms and long legs. So like I said, this one's going to be a little bit more advanced. So just skip it if you need to. I just want to give you some of you an option to work into the core. Let's come back into plank and then knees down and send it back. Very good. And roll your spine up. And then we're going to swing the legs in front of you. So some of you have asked about having surgery for scoliosis, if you have rods implanted in your spine, if you're fused. A lot of these are going to be out of the realm, I know, for you if you have that. So we'll work on another video that works a lot on hip stability and strengthening if you do have that going on. So if you have a fusion in your spine for any reason, if you've had surgery, anything like that, then obviously you're not going to be rolling through the spine. So keep that in mind, please, with these. So we're going to have legs out in front of you, arms in front, and I want you to curl your tailbone and roll yourself down with control till you're all the way onto your back. Bend your knees. Nice long spine here also. Knees are bent. We're going to go into a bridge. Exhale, curl the tailbone and roll yourself up. So if you've done video one, you know we do a lot of pelvic tilts and a lot of bridging. Inhale, exhale, curl and roll yourself back down. So we're just going to add some stability to this. So what I want you to do is roll up, curl the tailbone. Inhale at the top, exhale, roll down. We're going to do a few to warm up, and then we're going to add a little bit of hip stability. So what we're doing is strengthening glutes and hamstrings and hips, and then also working the mobility through the spine. And I'll show you a couple different things we're going to do. So on this one, we're going to roll up and stay there. Right? So stay here. Now, I want you to feel like your hips are on a skateboard, and what you're going to do is take your hips over to the right 1 inch and then roll down one vertebrae. Hips now to the left 1 inch and roll down one vertebrae. Right and roll down. Left and roll down. Right. Left. And work yourself all the way down your spine. This is going to feel a little bit funny and a little bit slow, but that's the point. This is so good. If you could do 10 of these a day, I won't make you do 10. We're just going to do 2. Okay, so once you get to the bottom, curl your tailbone, roll yourself back up in a normal bridge. Okay, get to the top. You're on a skateboard again. Take your hips to the left, then roll down 1 inch. Then take them to the right 1 inch and roll down basically one vertebrae or 1 inch. So what you're doing is try not to let your knees move too, actually. Try to keep the knees still, and it's just the hips moving side to side, and then you roll, side, roll, side, roll. So we're trying to make each little vertebrae move on its own. All right, inhale at the bottom, exhale, curl. We're going to roll back up and do a little more for the hip stability. Now try to keep the hips centered and level. Lift the right leg up to tabletop. Lower it down. Left leg. And down. So your goal is to keep the hips lifted, not let anything else move. So one of the keys to scoliosis is getting those hips nice and stable and strong. Inhale. Exhale, curl, rolling back down. Very nice. Let's hug the knees into the chest. Keep the right leg. Left leg straightens out. Left hand onto the knee. Take it over your body and across for a rotation stretch. So your knee is to the left, you're looking to the right. Come back up. Let's switch sides. Over, feeling that length as much as you can from fingertip. So on this side, left fingertip down to the left knee. And then come back to center. Let's straighten both legs out. Arms are back. Inhale. Exhale, tuck your chin, and we're just going to try to roll up one vertebrae at a time. If it doesn't happen, that's okay. You're just going to roll to your side and sit up over your legs. Restack, and let's bring the hands down, and we're going to come back to our starting warm-up a little bit just to see if it feels any different. So you're going to sit up nice and tall, whatever position you were sitting in to start, cross-legged or find your chair or your bench. We're going to bring the left arm up. And up and over. Inhale and exhale. And just see if there's any more freedom of movement now than there was. Feel like you're moving in between two panes of glass. So you're trying not to rotate forward or backward. Last one. And let's come up. And we're going to do the same thing with our rotation. Turn. Inhale up and turn. So maybe, just maybe, you're rotating and side bending a little farther. Maybe it feels a little more free. And back up. And let's bring hands down. And again, just go into your forward fold here, possibly walking your hands forward. Restack, switch the ankles if needed. One more, inhale, exhale, tuck your chin, walk forward. And all the way back up. And thank you so much for joining me today, and I hope you have a great week. Thanks for stopping by. So today we are going to do a Pilates scoliosis routine with some other exercises thrown in. The first one was so popular, I'm so glad you guys liked it. So hopefully this will just give you some options to that. So if you haven't checked out the first one, you can definitely check out Pilates for Scoliosis Part 1 and then add this to your routine as well. So we're going to work mostly on just a movement through the spine, and I'll talk as we go along. So I'm going to be sitting here on the ground, but if this isn't comfortable for you, and it definitely might not be, you're just going to find something to sit on, 2 inches, 4 inches, 6 inches, whatever you need. You can even sit in a chair and do this entire warm-up that we're going to do. So it's whatever is going to be comfortable for you. That's what matters, that you can have both sit bones down and then you can be up in this nice tall posture. I know that your curve is going to throw you a little bit one side to the other. That's why I want you to sit up if you need to. So I want you to just find that level that you need to sit on that's going to allow you to feel as tall as possible and allow your hips to relax a little bit. Okay, so once you find that, come on back and we will start. So what we're going to do is just have the hands on either side, and I want you literally to start to feel a little bit longer in each side waist, but let your shoulder blades drop down. So that's going to be one of the keys to this, is feeling the shoulder blades down as the spine gets nice and tall. We're going to sweep the left arm up and just lean over for what we call a mermaid stretch. It's just a simple side bend, and we're going to come right back up. Bring the left arm down, right arm over, and sweep it over. And we're going to do quite a few of these in this warm-up. So this is really meant to actually re-educate your spine. So I don't just want 2 or 3 stretches for people with scoliosis. Stretches are great, but 1 or 2 stretches isn't going to make a big difference as much as literally retraining your body how to move. One direction is going to feel much different to you, obviously, than the other direction when you're doing these side bends. And you're just going to go with it. I don't want you to judge yourself. I don't want you to get upset where you feel tight. All you're doing is letting your body move a little bit. Feel the movement. Feel the tightness. That's cool. It's fine. And you're just kind of working into those tight spaces a little bit. And maybe each time you go over, you're getting a little bit looser or a little bit longer. So on this one, we're going to reach over, stay there, just for that nice open stretch. Try to keep the sit bone down. And let's lift, bring the hand down and over to the other side. And then back up. All right, so that was our side bend. We're going to do a similar exercise for rotation. So I want you to bring your hands up towards the ceiling. We're going to rotate to the left first. You're going to come down. Your right hand comes to the outside of your knee. Your left hand comes behind you. You're going to come back up and switch sides. And again, all of these you can just do sitting in a chair or sitting wherever you need to. It's more the idea of either side bending or rotating through the spine, motions that they may not, your spine may not have done in quite a long time. Inhale, and then the breathing is important as well. Exhale and inhale. Breathing is going to help your spine move. So just find a breath pattern that works for you. And rotate. And up. And we'll just do a few more here. Again, it might seem like a lot of repetition, but that is the point. That's what I want. I want repetition and consistency, which if you've watched the other video, you know I talk a lot about. And up. Okay, so on this one, we're going to go over, and again, we're just going to stay there. You don't need to really crank or twist on your spine here. It's just a gentle rotation. I really want more of that idea of lifting up, pulling the belly button in towards the spine. And let's sweep the arms up and go to the other side. And again, maybe a gentle rotation and then a lift. Rotate, lift. So you'll see there's Pilates exercises through this and principles. There's a little bit of yoga. There's definitely physical therapy that I use for my patients. And then let's come back up. Arms come down, and I want you to walk yourself out. And we're just getting a stretch in the back, but also a stretch in the hips, especially if your legs are crossed at all. You're going to feel this in your hips. And let's just walk back up. If your legs are crossed, just cross them the other way. If they aren't, that's okay. Just leave your legs where they are, and we'll just do the same thing. Just forward fold or walk yourself out. And then we're going to walk back up from there. And then we're going to come around onto all fours. So some of these exercises are going to be similar video to video because they're so important for the spine. Let's start here, hands under the shoulders, knees under the hips. And let's exhale to round. And then inhale to arch. It just lets you practice a little more. It lets you add some different components. And here too, I don't want you to worry. The key is not worrying about what spots are moving, what spots aren't moving. Just move. Just let your body move. And if it's a little bit tight there, that's okay. See if you can maybe put a little more breath into the tight spots. Or maybe just go a little bit slower in the tight spots. But your body will find a way to move where it needs to if you're consistent with these exercises. Okay, let's go halfway in between. So this is your neutral spine. This is going to be a little different. It's a side bend. What I want you to do is think about having a tail, and you're going to twist and look at your hip. So I'm looking over my left shoulder. I'm sticking my left hip over to the left and trying to look at it. Then I'm coming to the other side and trying to look at my right hip. So it's like I have a tail, and I'm just wagging my tail side to side, looking at my tail. Then the other way. Keep pressing away from the hands. We'll just do one more in each direction. And then let's come back to center. Knees come wide. Press back for a child's pose. And then here too, we're going to add some stretches. I want you to walk your hands over to the left. Let the right hand cross on top. Let's stretch out the right side. Then let's come back to center. And take it to the other side. And then we're going to come back up to all fours and add some strengthening to that. So we're going to find your neutral spine again, which means you're going to round. And then you're going to arch. And then you're going to find a halfway point in between those two. And I want you to bring your right arm out in front of you. So the key here is not letting your spine move at all when you do this. I don't want your tail to stick up. I don't want your abs to drop. And then you might just hold this if you're okay with it. The left leg is going to go back behind you. So now I have my right arm reaching forward, left leg reaching back, and my belly is pulling in. So we're strengthening every muscle in your core and in your back here. It's called spinal balance. And let's just come back down and find the other side. Take the left arm in front of you. So it's really important not only to stretch and get movement in the spine, but then to strengthen the areas around it. Now take your right leg back. And breathe. And then come back. And we're going to do that again, alternating sides. Right arm, left leg. Slowly come back down. Left arm, right leg. And just check yourself each time to make sure that the spine isn't moving around, that you're keeping the core engaged. Feel like you have a glass of water on your back and on your tailbone, and you're trying to balance it there. And let's make this one the last one. And come back. All right, we're going to take it straight into a plank. I want you to take your hands forward slightly, knees come back, knees together, and we're going to shift forward into a plank on our knees. We're going to start with a modified plank here. Make sure the elbows aren't locked. So another great way to engage the core is to work on planking. Squeeze the legs together, nice long spine. If you have wrist or shoulder issues, you can do this down on your elbows right here, which is just fine. Okay, now let's just take it back. So your choice, we're going to do another plank. You can either stay on your knees or you can come up onto your toes. So I'll show you toes version. If you're going to do toes, separate your legs to hip distance and lift up onto your toes. And again, we're just going to breathe and hold it. Make sure the elbows aren't locked. You're nice and long here. All right, now from here, I want you to take it back into an inverted V. If you're familiar with yoga, it's similar to down dog. This also, you could just do on your knees if you need to. All right, now what I want you to do, this is going to be a little bit different and a little advanced. You're going to round out your spine. Okay, so from here, think cat. So instead of being a flat spine, I want you to round, round, round. You're going to come forward over your toes and then lift. And here is your extension. Okay, over your toes, round, back into your flexion. So this is just like our cat camel that we did, except it's up. And we'll do one more onto long arms and long legs. So like I said, this one's going to be a little bit more advanced. So just skip it if you need to. I just want to give you some of you an option to work into the core. Let's come back into plank and then knees down and send it back. Very good. And roll your spine up. And then we're going to swing the legs in front of you. So some of you have asked about having surgery for scoliosis, if you have rods implanted in your spine, if you're fused. A lot of these are going to be out of the realm, I know, for you if you have that. So we'll work on another video that works a lot on hip stability and strengthening if you do have that going on. So if you have a fusion in your spine for any reason, if you've had surgery, anything like that, then obviously you're not going to be rolling through the spine. So keep that in mind, please, with these. So we're going to have legs out in front of you, arms in front, and I want you to curl your tailbone and roll yourself down with control till you're all the way onto your back. Bend your knees. Nice long spine here also. Knees are bent. We're going to go into a bridge. Exhale, curl the tailbone and roll yourself up. So if you've done video one, you know we do a lot of pelvic tilts and a lot of bridging. Inhale, exhale, curl, and roll yourself back down. So we're just going to add some stability to this. So what I want you to do is roll up, curl the tailbone. Inhale at the top, exhale, roll down. We're going to do a few to warm up, and then we're going to add a little bit of hip stability. So what we're doing is strengthening glutes and hamstrings and hips, and then also working the mobility through the spine. and I'll show you a couple different things we're gonna do. So on this one, we're gonna roll up and stay there, right? So stay here. Now, I want you to feel like your hips are on a skateboard, and what you're gonna do is take your hips over to the right 1 inch, and then roll down one vertebrae. Hips now to the left 1 inch, and roll down one vertebrae. Right, and roll down. Left, and roll down. Right, left. And work yourself all the way down your spine. This is going to feel a little bit funny and a little bit slow, but that's the point. This is so good. If you could do 10 of these a day, I won't make you do 10, we're just gonna do 2. Okay, so once you get to the bottom, curl your tailbone, roll yourself back up in a normal bridge. Okay, get to the top, you're on a skateboard again, take your hips to the left, then roll down 1 inch. Then take them to the right 1 inch and roll down basically one vertebrae or 1 inch. So what you're doing is try not to let your knees move too, actually. Try to keep the knees still, and it's just the hips moving side to side, and then you roll, side, roll, side, roll. So we're trying to make each little vertebrae move on its own. All right, inhale at the bottom, exhale, curl. We're gonna roll back up and do a little more for the hip stability. Now try to keep the hips centered and level. Lift the right leg up to tabletop, lower it down, left leg, and down. So your goal is to keep the hips lifted, not let anything else move. So one of the keys to scoliosis is getting those hips nice and stable and strong. Inhale, exhale, curl. Rolling back down. Very nice. Let's hug the knees into the chest. Keep the right leg. Left leg straightens out. Left hand onto the knee. Take it over your body and across for a rotation stretch. So your knee is to the left, you're looking to the right. Come back up. Let's switch sides. Over, feeling that length as much as you can from fingertips. So on this side, left fingertip down to the left knee. And then come back to center. Let's straighten both legs out. Arms are back. Inhale. Exhale, tuck your chin, and we're just gonna try to roll up one vertebrae at a time. If it doesn't happen, that's okay. You're just gonna roll to your side and sit up. Over your legs. Restack, and let's bring the hands down. And we're gonna come back to our starting warm-up a little bit just to see if it feels any different. So you're gonna sit up nice and tall, whatever position you were sitting in to start, cross-legged or find your chair or your bench. We're gonna bring the left arm up and up and over. Inhale and exhale. And just see if there's any more freedom of movement now than there was. Feel like you're moving in between two panes of glass. So you're trying not to rotate forward or backward. Last one. And let's come up, and we're gonna do the same thing with our rotation. Turn, inhale up, and turn. So maybe, just maybe, you're rotating and side bending a little farther. Maybe it feels a little more free. And back up. And let's bring hands down. And again, just go into your forward fold here, possibly walking your hands forward. Restack, switch the ankles if needed. One more, inhale, exhale, tuck your chin, walk forward. And all the way back up. And thank you so much for joining me today, and I hope you have a great week.